Hi, I'm Amanda Demolsky. I'm an outdoor skills specialist here with Metroparks Toledo. We are at Wiregrass Lake Metropark, which is one of our newer Metroparks in our park family, just opened a few years ago. And it's kind of one of the hidden gems of the Metroparks that a lot of people don't know about. There's a really nice hiking trail that you can take around the lake. We do have three primitive campsites for people that would like to try tent camping. And then, of course, the focus of this park is the gorgeous lake here, which is available for fishing and also paddling as well. At Metroparks Toledo, we have a fleet of canoes, kayaks, and stand-up paddle boards. And this pond has really nice, really clean, quality water. So we do a lot of those stand-up paddle boarding, canoeing, and kayaking programs here at this park. We're here today to talk about paddling. So for those of you that are paddlers out there, you're probably like me and you're waiting for that nice warm spring day when you can finally get out on the water, dust the dust off your boat, and get back out here. What a lot of paddlers think about when they think about spring paddling is the air temperature. And it's really, really important as a paddler that you think not just about the air temperature, but more importantly about the water temperature. So you can have a gorgeous day in April where it's 75 degrees outside, but water takes a lot longer than air to heat up. So on that 75 degree day in April, your water temperature might still be 40 degrees. And if you run into trouble and you capsize, you're gonna find yourself in a situation where you're battling hypothermia very, very rapidly. So we always recommend to people that you should not go out and paddle until your air and water temperature combined add up to 120 degrees overall. Also, you should not go out to paddle if your water temperature is below 60 degrees, unless you have some of the gear that we're gonna talk about here that can help extend your paddle season. All right, so if we are hoping to paddle when our water temperature is below 60 degrees, it's really important that you always dress for immersion. So what that means is you always anticipate that you're going for a swim, because accidental swims can happen to even experienced paddlers at any time. So always assume you're gonna dump your boat, and you need to make sure that you are dressed appropriately, that you are not going to be in a situation where you're becoming hypothermic in that cold water if you were to dump your boat. So if you're paddling and the water temperature is below 60 degrees, you really should be wearing a wetsuit, or ideally a dry suit, which we don't have here, but a wetsuit, which we have here. If you were to get wet, this holds the water against your skin and heats the water up, and it makes an insulating layer that will help you keep warm if you were to dump as you are paddling. You'll notice my wetsuit is a paddling wetsuit, so it doesn't have arms because the arms will chafe as you're paddling. So under my wetsuit, I wear a base layer like Under Armour to kind of keep you warm as a layer against your skin there. I take my nice neoprene wetsuit, and I am going to pair that with very warm neoprene booties here, again, to insulate my feet. These are my short booties, but I even have a pair that come up nice and high on my calves for really cold weather to make sure that I'm staying nice and toasty warm. So that's kind of the base of what I would want in my paddling outfit for cold weather. Over top of that base layer, then my insulating wetsuit. If it's chilly, I'm even gonna add another insulating layer over top of that. Now, you wanna be very careful that you avoid cotton at all costs. Cotton does not insulate when it gets wet, and it will not keep you warm. So I'm looking at a nice fleece insulating layer here. Wool would also work as well. So I've got my fleece layer that I would layer over top of my wetsuit. And then I have a waterproof layer on top of that to keep the splashage off of me if it drizzles a little bit. This is waterproof, and it keeps all of that water off of me, a nice shell here. This is a paddling jacket, but raincoats will work as well. This is a little more specific and works a little bit better for the situation to really make sure that I'm staying dry from all the water splashing up on top of me. Of course, if it's chilly outside, you gotta keep your hands warm. So I have some fleece-lined neoprene paddling gloves to keep you nice and toasty. And then, of course, you'll want a hat. You lose a lot of heat through your head, believe it or not. So wearing a hat is a great thing to keep you warm. Of course, you always, always, always wanna make sure that you wear a properly fitted personal flotation device when you're paddling. That's the number one thing you can do to keep yourself safe. It's even more important in cold water, because if you dump in cold water, your body quickly loses the ability to swim. Doesn't matter how good a swimmer you are, your nerves and your muscles just stop working. So if you don't have a life jacket on, you can be an Olympic swimmer and you'll be in a lot of trouble. So please make sure you are always wearing a life jacket when paddling. And then if it's chilly, I'm also going to have something called a spray skirt to help keep water out of my boat. When you paddle, water kind of drips into your lap and you get wet. This is something that would go around your waist and then snap around the cockpit of the boat and keep a lot of that water out to keep you a little bit warmer, and it can help preserve or extend your paddling season, allow you to paddle when it's a little bit chillier. This is more of a summer weight nylon one, but they make winter weight neoprene ones as well. So that's a little bit of the gear that we would need to paddle in those chilly conditions. If you're looking for additional information on paddling and paddling safety, please check out Metroparks Toledo. We do a lot of paddling safety classes. You can learn different paddle strokes. We teach rescues classes where you can learn how to capsize your kayak, get yourself back in, get a friend or a family member back in their kayak, and a lot of the different safety that you really need to be safe on the water. So look out for those paddling safety classes on the website.